Hi, I'm Christine the Mean. Today I'm going to start a new series called Rants and Raves. And in Rants and Raves, I will be making short videos to dive into various topics related to mobile gaming and mobile esports. Today we're going to do chapter one, which is why are we talking about mobile gaming and mobile esports at all? So I have a couple of reasons that I think mobile gaming is interesting. I've been playing Clash of Clans for 7 years, and I have been playing Rules of Survival, PUBG Mobile, and Call of Duty Mobile for almost a year. And played a little bit of Clash Royale, I've played some auto chess. So I've played kind of across a range of different kinds of mobile games. But some of the things that I think are really important here are that I've been a lifelong gamer. I'm almost 50 now, so I am well outside of the normal demographic that the gaming industry thinks of as their target audience. But I've been playing pretty intensely for years. And I started playing games when I was 8 years old. So am I going to stop playing games as I age? I don't think so. At the same time, my parents, when I look at my parents, they've been in bridge clubs forever. They've played bridge, it's a card game. They've been in organized competitions, but there aren't really any new young people going into bridge clubs. They just aren't going there. So some of the needs that have been met in the past by things like bridge clubs included this sense of a game and a sense of a competition, as well as a sense of social connection. And I have found a lot of those things in my mobile gaming, in Clash of Clans, in Call of Duty Mobile. There's both this sense of strategy in game and competition that's inherent in the platform, as well as this sense of social connection that can be developed because you're part of a clan or because you're part of a team and you have to communicate with your clan or with your team in order to be successful. So I see mobile games as a potential replacement for the Bridge Club. I also think that mobile games are really enabling with their portability. The fact that you can play a mobile game from the parking lot of a grocery store while sitting in your car, or you can play it from a hospital bed, or you can play it from a hotel room when you're on a business trip or on vacation, you can take these with you, and you can integrate these into your life in a way that is much more difficult with a gaming PC or a console that's plugged in. So I think that the mobile platform offers great opportunity for an ever-expanding user base. Now, that makes sense for mobile games, and a lot of time, and everybody would agree that, yeah, there's a lot more people playing mobile games, we all have phones, let's play. But where's this connection to esports? Well, here's where it is. Esports, at the base of them, are supposed to be entertainment. They're supposed to be like you're gonna go watch somebody else who's really good at this play because you wanna cheer for your team, because there's somebody with exceptional skills that you are interested in watching, because you like the drama of the competition. But that esport has to be entertaining for the spectator. And I think that any game or any sport is actually more interesting if you've tried to play it, if you have an understanding of the rules, if you have an understanding of how the gameplay goes, you're much more likely to become engaged and to come back and to come back again. So there is an increase in esports. I see that as an inevitability. And I think that mobile and incorporating mobile into that is a potential way to increase your audiences faster, to increase the engagement faster. I am far more likely to go watch a competition of people playing Clash of Clans, a game that I have played intensely, than I am to go watch a competition of people playing Destiny, because I've never played that game. So I don't even know what that game is. I just know that it exists. So that's why I think mobile gaming is important and why I think mobile esports are important. I think there's demographic reasons in the US. I think that the mobile platform opens up opportunity for people from around the world, sense of social connection. I think there's a whole bunch of things that kind of come together that say there's going to be some opportunity here. And I don't think there's that many people looking at this opportunity right now. So here I am. I'm looking at it. I see it. I can taste it, and I'm excited about it. So this is the end of Rants and Raves number one with Christine the Mean. I hope to catch you next time for whatever chapter two is. In the meantime, please follow me on Twitter or catch me on one of my live Twitch streams and let's have some conversations. This is Christine the Mean signing off.